Hello everyone, this is Akang Suman here. Now we will do questions based on the epicyclic gear train. In the question, it is given that an epicyclic gear train, an arm carries two gears A and B having 36 and 45 teeth respectively. So what is given in the questions? The teeth of the gear A and the teeth of the gear B. So I'm just writing here TA, that is 36, and TB is 45. Okay. In the question, it is given that if the arm rotate at 150 rpm in the anticlockwise direction about the center of gear A, which is fixed. So what is saying, you need to understand, there are two gears A and B and both are connected. That means the both are having one single arm, that is common arm for gear A and B. Okay, this arm is going to be rotated 150 rpm in anti-clockwise direction. So I'm assuming that the anti-clockwise direction as negative. Okay, and it is about the center of gear A. So I'm just drawing the diagram so you will be able to understand what it is saying. So this is gear A and this is gear B. Okay, I'm making the gear B as bigger as compared to gear A because there are a number of teeth in the gear B having more than that of A. So this is basically gear B, okay, and this is A. A is fixed. That means gear A is rotating about the fixed center. But here there is an arm which is going to be rotated at 150 rpm in anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise means in that direction, okay, that would be the direction for arm, okay, anti-clockwise. Now see here, we all know the definitions of the epicyclic gear train. Apart from the rotation of the gear, if any axis, any gear axis is in rotations with respect to some other axis, then we call it as a epicyclic gear train. Here you can see gear B, gear axis of the gear B is in rotations with respect to the axis of the gear A. Okay. And if you want to find out the degree of freedom for the epicyclic gear train, it would comes out to be 2. Okay. In the last video, we have calculated the degree of freedom for epicyclic gear train. You can calculate it using the pushback equations. F is equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. Okay. So there will be degree of freedom is equal to 2. So what is in the question, it is asking that the speed of the gear B, we have to calculate the speed of the gear B. In the question, it is not mentioned about the speed of the gear A, and we have to calculate the speed of the gear B. So first we draw the table, and I already told you how can we draw the table for the epicyclic gear train. That is, here this is motions and this is arm, and this is gear A and this is gear B. We have to draw the table. So I'm just drawing you here. That is the one block and this is second. In this table, we will mention the speed of gear A, B and arm. Okay. So again, I'm going to tell you how to draw the table. So this is motion. First, we are assuming that the arm is fixed. In the first block, I'm writing here arm is fixed. If arm is fixed, that means arm is having no motions, it is no rotations. Okay, and I'm assuming that A is having rotations x rpm. This is x. I'm assuming x plus x, this is basically plus x. That means I'm assuming that A is having rotation of x rpm in clockwise direction. Okay, I'm assuming that it is x rpm in the clockwise direction. Okay, so here arm is having the zero velocity and A is, I am assuming the x, that is the velocity of the gear A, okay, and we all know that the teeth of the gear A is TA and teeth of the gear B is TB. Okay, so what would be the speed of the gear B when the arm is having zero velocity? So it would be, since it is in, if it is in clockwise direction, it would be in anticlockwise, okay, because both are meeting gears. So that would be minus x TA, teeth of A upon teeth of B. Okay, this would comes out from velocity ratio. We have studied the velocity ratio, and we all know that the velocity ratio is inversely proportional to the teeth on the gears. Okay, so here I'm just writing here that NA upon NB is equal to, you can write it as omega A upon omega B. So that would be TB upon TA. Okay, so if you want to find out the speed of the B, that is NB, you have to write down NA multiply TA upon TB. Okay, but here if I'm talking about the direction, if x is in a clockwise direction, that is plus x, then it is meeting gears, B is meeting gears, so it would be in anticlockwise direction. Okay, now I have assumed in the first block that arm is fixed and having no motions. Okay, now in the second block I have to write down arm is free. Arm is free. So the arm rotations is, I'm assuming that plus y, that means it is in rotations and clockwise direction with the y rpm. This is a general table that I'm going to draw. Okay, we will arrange this according to the given data, don't worry. So that is if it is plus x plus y, so that would be y plus x. Okay, because now arm is free to rotate, now it would be y minus x TA upon TB. It will affect the velocity of gear A as well as gear B. Okay, now what is given in the questions? In the question it is given that arm is rotated at 150 rpm in anticlockwise direction. So anticlockwise is considered as negative. Okay, so y is equal to minus 150. Okay, now you are able to understand. Now minus 150 rpm, you have to make the table first, that is general table. Okay, you have to make the table, then you have to put the values. Okay, whatever be the given data in the questions. So y is equal to minus 150. Now it is saying that the center of the gear A is fixed. That means A is having zero velocity of rotations. That means NA is equal to zero. That means I can write here x plus y is equal to zero. Because what is the speed of the A? This is, because here in the question arm is free to rotate. So we have to use this this block. Okay, this table we have to use. Okay, so x plus y is equal to 0, that means x is equal to x minus 150, because y is equal to minus 50. So you will get x is equal to 150. What is the meaning of the x is equal to 150? X is equal to 150 rpm means, x is equal to 150 rpm means what? This is in clockwise direction, plus 150 it is. Okay, now in the question it is asking about the speed of the B. Now what is the speed of the B? Y minus X TA upon TB. Okay, so what is Y? Y is minus 150, and what is X? That is also 150. Multiply TA, teeth on the gear A is given in the question, that is 36 and B is 45. Now here you can calculate the final answer. 150 multiply 36 upon 45, you will get 120. So finally you will get minus 270 rpm. Okay, minus 270 rpm, that is the speed of the B. What is the meaning of either here? Minus sign denotes this is in anticlockwise direction. Okay, that you can write it as 270 rpm clockwise, anticlockwise. एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. ओके, हियर यू कैन क्रॉस चेक आल्सो बिकॉज हियर देयर विल बी एक्स इज इक्वल टू 150 आरपीएम, दैट इज इन अ क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. सो ऑफ कोर्स इट वुड बी इन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. सो हियर यू हैव टू यूज ईदर साइन ओके विद द मैग्नीट्यूड, और यू हैव टू mention the direction whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. Okay, so it would be the final answer, that is 270. So I hope you are getting my points. You will be able to understand the solution of that questions. We will do some more questions. Okay, so that you are able to understand how to draw the table. Table is important. As you are able to make the table accurately, this is in the, and the data remaining, that is the simplest thing. You just have to put the value and you'll get the answer. Okay, so in the below here you can see, here I don't do any special thing, just I draw the table and just I put the value whatever be the given in the questions. Okay, and we will get the final answer. So that is in the basically getting the thing that is important, how to make the table. Okay, you just have to make the table accurately. As you will make the table accurately, the answer would be according to the table. If you make any mistake to draw the table, you'll get the wrong answer. Okay, so make the table, practice how to make the table accurately. Do the lot of questions, do the lot of practice questions on the epicyclic gate, and then you'll be able to understand how to draw the table, because one question is fixed in the gate examinations and it is of 2 marks question.